things in many ways. Growth using a tape measure, Facebook posts using number of likes. But how do you measure your health? When you wake up in the morning, roll over, you're ready to put your feet on the floor, how do you know that your body is ready for what's ahead? 2 months ago, when I woke up and I was about to put my feet on the floor, I realized these feet weren't taking me anywhere. No, these are not ski boots getting ready for the storm that you're about to get. Some people said I was accessorizing tonight. Broken bones, both feet. And I didn't have a measure of how bad really was. I never thought I would be a subject in my own research. And if I hadn't been, I wouldn't have had a measure these last 2 months of my own recovery. You see, vital signs are measures of the body's most basic functions. We use them to monitor health, to detect medical problems, and to monitor recovery for those that have medical problems. They're really easy. They're meant to be able to be used anywhere, at home, in medical settings. Healthcare providers most commonly recognize these five around the globe. And I expect that many of you have likely used one or more of these in monitoring your own health or someone else in your family, maybe temperature or pain, using that information to then trigger, what should I do next? Should I call a pediatrician? Should I call primary care? Vital signs give us that information for action. And globally, we're beginning to recognize the importance of a sixth vital sign, and that's mobility. Our ability to move is associated with every system in our body. It is an ideal sixth vital sign. We know that for people who aren't moving at the rate they need to be for their age and for their gender, we see decreased blood flow, decreased oxygen uptake, reduced muscle strength, differences in their bone density. We know that mobility is associated with our mental and our emotional health. And because mobility is associated with every body system, complications from immobility can range from pneumonia and constipation to cardiovascular disease and depression. There are a lot of measures of mobility and function, but there isn't a standard in healthcare. We need to adopt one metric globally. We need something as simple and something as routine as temperature or blood pressure. And so with all of you tonight, we're going to establish a new measurement standard for physical health using walking speed. Walking speed. A measure of someone's normal walking pace, mine a little bit slower right now, the distance they travel at a normal pace over a period of time. It can be measured in as short a space as I have here, or in as few as 2 minutes. Sounds simple, doesn't it? It is, and it's so important. Did you know that you need to be able to walk 1.1 meters per second to be able to safely cross a street, 2.5 miles per hour? So it's about like this, about the pace you would walk to a meeting you actually want to go to. For an older adult who walks 2.2 miles per hour or less, we can expect to see cognitive impairment within 5 years. For a man that's 70, who walks that pace, 2.2 miles per hour, as his normal pace, we can predict his life expectancy to be about 84 years. If he walked 3.1 miles per hour, we would predict at 70 that he would live to be 90. We have a tremendous opportunity today to launch a social movement to create walking speed and mobility to be the sixth vital sign. I invite you today to take out your phones and go to this website, sixthvitalsign.dcri.org, and join us. Click on Learn More, and please provide us with your email so that we can invite you to participate in this social movement. What we need to do is get measures of walking speed for an unlimited population, people of all ages, men and women, around the globe, we expect that walking speed likely varies by where you live and many other things. The more people who participate, the better our predictions can be. The more diverse the population, the more information we can provide. We're aiming to create maps of norms and risks. We want to be able to create normative curves, like what you would see with your height and weight charts that we use at home, in communities, schools, in healthcare. We want to be able to give people the information they need to discuss their health with their family and with healthcare providers, and to take action if it's needed. Now, this is a mobile health study of mobility. Many of you might have seen the TV show Shark Tank. We had a devil's tank. They were looking to invest in the next idea that would go forward with Apple's research kit, this concept one. That was in June, just a few short months ago, because it was recognized that we could use the Six Vital Sign app to move population health forward. So I invite you today to consider participating in this social movement. Because if we had every person in the Denver community as alum participating, it would be the largest study of walking speed. And imagine if you invited just one other person to participate with you. There are a lot of people who don't use their smartphones for health. My husband, until December, still had a flip phone, and he was okay with it. And you think of the number of people who don't even have phones. And then we have so many people in this country at risk for decline who don't know it. People who have chronic disease, illness, injury, have limitations in their activities of daily living. Please invite them. Invite your grandparents, your neighbors, your coworkers, because they're less likely to participate in a mobile health study, but they can participate on your phone. So I thank you for your commitment to Duke, to research, and your commitment to moving the population's health forward, because together as a Duke community, we can establish mobility using walking speed as the sixth vital sign. Thank you.